In the previous video, I went over how to document your data using a QAQC form. In this video, I will show you how to correct spatial reference systems using the Define Projection tool and create new copies of the data in a new spatial reference using the Project tool. Regarding the instructions on the Humboldt State online website, I'm currently on step 25. However, just for future reference, these numbers sometimes change. In this activity, the goal is to have a copy of all four data layers using the spatial reference WGS 1984 UTM Zone 10 North. To start, I'll set the data frame to this spatial reference. Back in ArcMap, right-click on the word Layers in the table of contents and open the data frame property. Navigate to the Coordinate System tab. Open the Projected Coordinate Systems folder and scroll down until you see UTM. In the UTM folder, scroll down and open WGS 1984. Open the Northern Hemisphere. Select 10 North and then click OK. You'll see a warning. Take a moment to read through it. ArcMap is telling you that the layers in the table of contents use a different coordinate system than the one used by the data frame. It's warning you that there may be accuracy problems. You're going to fix this problem in the next few steps. For now, click Yes. Before we create copies of the data in the UTM spatial reference, we first have to fix the problems with the Alaska layer and the federal lands layer. Let's start with the federal lands. If you will recall from previous steps, the federal lands has an unknown spatial reference. ArcMap can draw the federal lands, but it does not know where to place it on the Earth. In the Lab3 data folder, there is a text file with some metadata documentation about this layer. Looking through the file, I found that the spatial reference is supposed to be in a geographic coordinate system using the North American datum of 1983. I'll use the Define Projection tool to let ArcMap know that this was a spatial reference used to create the shapefile. Open Arc Toolbox and navigate to Data Management, Projections and Transformations, then Define Projection. For the input, I'll enter the Federal Lands layer. I'll then set the spatial reference by clicking the button to the right. I'll open the Geographic folder, then North America, then select NAD 1983. When I click OK, the federal lands appear where they are supposed to on Earth. Next, I'll correct the spatial reference for Alaska. It's obvious there's a problem with the Alaska layer because ArcMap has placed it over Humboldt County. This type of problem can happen when the spatial reference has been defined incorrectly. First, I need to find out what spatial reference was used when the data file was first created. The Alaska layer also has a text file with metadata. When the file was created, it was an NAD UTM Zone 5. Again, I'll use the Define Projection tool to tell ArcMap what the correct spatial reference is. Once I do that, Alaska is placed in the correct position on Earth. With all of my spatial reference systems corrected, I can now create new data files that use the WGS UTM Zone 10 North spatial reference system. To do this, I'll use the Project tool for the vector data and the Project Raster tool for the topographic layer. I'll start with the Project Raster tool for the USGS topographic map. In the Arc Toolbox, locate the Project Raster tool. For the input, I'll use the topographic map layer. I'll save the output to the working folder. I'll navigate to WGS UTM Zone 10 North spatial reference system and run the tool. For the remaining layers, I will use the Project tool, which has the same steps but is for vector data only. To test to make sure that all of my data is correct, I'll close ArcMap and open a new blank map document. I'll add each of the layers from the working folder, one at a time. If you don't see any error messages, then you know that each of the layers is in the same spatial reference system. Registered students will need to turn in the contents of the working folder, which should contain the QAQC forms for the three shapefiles. The working folder should also contain a copy of each of the data layers projected into the WGS84 UTM Zone 10 North spatial reference. There should be no errors present. Right-click on your working folder, select 7-zip, then add to working.7z.